Pictures.
Hello, 12.
Hello, 13.
Hello, love.
Changes all.
Down below.
Up above.
Time to doubt.
It's a mess.
It's a mess. Time to go.
Time to go.
Next day I went to the doctor down the block, sure enough, acute appendicitis. They rushed me right to the hospital. Well, I figured this book would cover everything the rest of my life. And when I was 13, I had my first wet dream. I went right back to the book. Milky discharge, milky discharge, milky discharge. Gonorrhea, I was in shock, I mean gonorrhea. Before it even started, I was terrified. I couldn't even tell my mother that I had gonorrhea. So the book said drink a lot of water.
Is that all the book said?
No, it said take penicillin, strepto, something or the other, but I couldn't do that unless I told somebody. So all I could do was drink the water, and I drank like 20 glasses a day for 3 weeks. I almost drowned. Finally, I went to confession and told the priest that I had gonorrhea. Well, he was in shock too.
Ooh, have you been with my son?
Nobody, nobody, nobody.
Then how can you have gonorrhea?
Well, I told him about the book's diagnosis for milky discharge, and he set me straight. That's the only time the church has ever really helped me out. Well, I was
4'10", 4'10". That's the story of my life. I remember when everybody was my size. Boy, was that great. But then everybody started moving up, and there I was stuck at 4'10", 4'10". But I kept hoping and praying. I used to hang from a parallel bar by the hour, hoping I'd stretch just an inch more. 'Cause I was into dancing then, and I was good. And I wanted so much to be a prima ballerina. Then I went out for cheerleader. And they told me, no dice, you'll get lost on the football field. The pom-poms are bigger than you. I spent my whole childhood waiting to grow tits. When am I gonna grow tits?
Secret. My whole life was a secret.
One little fart, and they called me stinky for 3 years.
Goodbye, 12. Goodbye, 13. Hello,
Daniel Craig, Daniel Craig, my God, Daniel Craig.
Oh, down below.
Playing doctor with Evelyn.
La la la.
I'll show you mine.
La la.
You show me yours.
La la.
Seeing daddy naked.
Time to go. Time to go.
Surprise.
La la la.
Mom and dad are doing it.
I'm gonna be a movie star.
But you see, the only thing that grew about me was my desire. I was never gonna be Maria Tolchi. I was just this peanut on point. That was my whole trip. My size. It still is. God, the last show I was in, I was 29 and I played a 14.
Aha! The year of the snake. 29.
Well, I don't look it and I shouldn't knock it because I've always been able to work. From the time I was 5 and King and I, King and I. Up till now, I never stopped. 'Cause whatever I am
so excited.
excited because I'm gonna go to the High School of Performing Arts. I mean, I was dying to be this serious actress. Anyway, it's the first day of acting class and we're in the auditorium. And the teacher, Mr. Karp. Ugh, Mr. Karp. Anyway, he puts us up on stage with our legs around each other, one in back of the other. And he says, okay, today we're going to do improvisation. You're on a bobsled. It's snowing out. And it's cold. Okay, go. Every day for a week we would try to feel the motion down the hill. Every day for a week we would try to hear the wind rush, feel the chill. So I dug right down to the bottom of my soul to see what I had inside. Yes, I dug right down to the bottom of my soul and I tried, and everybody's going whoosh, whoosh. I feel the snow, I feel the cold, I feel the air. And Mr. Karp turns to me and he says, okay, Morales, what do you feel? And I said, nothing, I'm feeling nothing. And he said nothing could get a girl transferred. They all felt something, but I felt nothing except the feeling that this bullshit was absurd. But I told myself, hey, it's only the first week. Maybe it's genetic. They don't have bobsleds in San Juan. Second week, more advanced, and we had to be a table, be a sports car, ice cream cone. Mr. Karp, he would say, very good, except Morales. Try Morales all alone. So I dug right down to the bottom of my soul to see how an ice cream felt. Yes, I dug right down to the bottom of my soul and I tried to melt. The kids yelled nothing. They called me nothing. And Karp allowed it, which really makes me burn. They were so helpful. They called me hopeless until I really didn't know where else to turn. And Karp kept saying, Morales, I think you should transfer to girls' high. You'll never be an actress. Never. Jesus Christ! Went to church praying, Santa Maria, send me guidance. Send me guidance on my knees. Went to church praying, Santa Maria, help me feel it. Help me feel it. Pretty please. And the voice from down at the bottom of my soul came up to the top of my head. There's a voice from down at the bottom of my soul. Here is what it says. This man is nothing. This course is nothing. If you want something, go find a better glass. And when you find one, you'll be an actress. And I assure you that's what finally came to pass. 6 months later, I heard that Karp had died. And I dug right down to the bottom of my soul and cry, 'cause I felt nothing.
I turned 15. I lied about my age so that I could join AGBA. You know,
the nightclub union. Cause I could make a couple hundred a week working these strip joints outside of Kansas City. Worked this one club for about 8 weeks straight, and I really became friendly with this stripper. Her name was Lola Letard, and her dynamic twin 44s. Well, she really took to me. I mean, we didn't share the only dressing room, and she did a lot of dressing. Anyway, she used to come and pick me up and drive me to work nights. Well, the neighbors would all be hanging outside of their windows, and she'd drive up in her big pink Cadillac convertible and smile. And I'd come tripping out of the house with my little tuxedo on and my tap shoes in my hand, and we just
had 12, goodbye 13, hello love.
Where do I pay for all those lessons? Dance for grandma, dance for grandma.
To the movies until you finish your homework. Wash the car.
Stop picking your nose. Oh, darling, you're not old enough to wear a bra. You've got nothing to hold it up.
Locked in the bathroom with Pornhub.com.
Tits? When am I gonna grow tits?
If Jake Gyllenhaal could be a movie star, then I could be a movie star.
Well, when the guys in the block all saw Lola, they all wanted to know what the story was. So I told them about this big hot romance we were having. But actually, she was going with this
little brat. That's what my sister was. A little brat. And that's why I shaved her head. I'm glad I shaved her head. But then my father lost his job, so we had to leave El Paso. Well, it was the furthest thing from my mind to be a dancer, but my mother would embarrass me. Then when she'd come to pick me up at school with all those great big yellow rollers in her hair, no matter how much I begged her, and she'd say, "What? Are you ashamed of your own mother?" But the thing that made my daddy laugh so much was when I used to jump and dance around the living room.
Please take this message.
Mom to penthouse, she'd come home with her shoes in her hair.
Mama fat, always in the kitchen, happy never grew. You're Maggie, I can tell you now. Your father went through life with an open fly.
Take after your father's side of the family, the ugly side.
Wait until your father gets home. Swear to God, you hope to die.
And it was the first time I'd ever seen a dead body. But then when I was 15, the most terrible thing happened. America's Got Talent held auditions in St. Louis, and I didn't hear about it till after they had gone, and I nearly killed myself, nearly killed myself. I tried to walk in front of a speeding streetcar. I remember noticing boys for the first time. Anyway, I remember practicing kissing with Leslie. Well, she was my best girlfriend. Did any of you ever practice kissing with another girl? So that when the time came, you know how to. No. Oh my God.
Judy?
Did you girl?
Yeah, but just a couple of times.
So count me in.
Oh, thank God. Anyway, I do remember.
The worst thing in school was every time the teacher'd call on me, I'd be hard. Really, I'd have to lean up against the desk like this. And the teacher would say, "Stand up straight." I can't. I have a pain in my side. Stand up straight. Or walking down the hall, I'd have to walk like this. With all your books stacked up in front of you.
I thought it was me. I thought I was a sex maniac.
You are.
I did too. I mean, it didn't go down for 3 years.
Oh, and the bus. Well, the bus was the worst. I mean, I just look at a bus and bingo. Well, there was this one time I was hooking up in the back seat with Sally Ketchum. We were making out, and I was feeling her boobs and really feeling her boobs. And after about an hour or so, she says, "Ooh, don't you want to feel anything else?" And I suddenly thought to myself, "No, I don't."
Did that come as a surprise to you?
Well, I guess, yeah. It was probably the first time I realized I was a homo. And I got so depressed because I thought being gay meant being an outcast all the rest of my life. A bum. And I thought, gee, I'll never get to wear fierce clothes. And I was so into fashion then. I had this fabulous pair of vintage Ferragamo shoes.
Goodbye, 12.
Early to bed.
Goodbye, 13.
Early to
bed. Goodbye, 12.
Goodbye, 12. Goodbye, 12. From last year. Thought shit.
Shivity,
shit.
Shivity,
shivity. What are you got?